And a very good morning to you, Grenada, and the rest of the world. It's a beautiful sunny morning here in the Spice Isle. And with that, here's Georgie Porgy saying welcome to the Wednesday edition of Good Day, Grenada. Boy, do we have a zinger. It seems like I say that at the start of every program, but do we have a zinger for you? I'm just going to start with a little tease. Take a look. See that? If only we could get her in the center of the frame by the time we bring her on there a little later on. Yeah, that's our good friend Sharon Roberts. She's going to be with us in the last half of today's program. And guess what? Not only is she going to be joined by her dear hubby, gentleman by the name of Mr. Winty, as we call him here. Grenada's biggest cricket fan. That's all I can tell you. Not only is he going to be joining us, but let me tell you, are you in for some entertainment this morning? Are you in for some entertainment this morning? That's all I'm going to say right now. So you can sit there and lick your lips, because there's all kinds of stuff coming up. However, well before we get to Sharon, we're going to start, here they come on social media. Good morning, Margaret. Take those sunglasses off, girl. What are you hiding from? And John is also saying, wet and windy Wednesday? Wet in Carriacou? John, man, I better send some of that sunshine we got down here up to you. Can't believe it. And hey, Chester is also having a rainy morning in Zurich, Switzerland. Wow, how come we're so blessed down here? I guess we're just a very special breed of people on the Spice Isle. Anyhow, let's get down to brass tacks. We're gonna start with a little piece that's captioned, "The Revenge of the Poor is Here." What the heck is he talking about? Again, since I'm in the suspense mood this morning, we'll keep you in suspense and you'll have to find out what that's about in just a wee bit. It's coming up real soon. We're also going to take a look at what fireworks are like in Japan. Yaman. If you have never seen what these folks put on, just wait until you see what we got coming your way in just a short while. And then we do have your favorite, the National Report. And then, of course, we will get to good old Sharon and Winty. I see him in the frame right now. I hope he has recovered. Boy, oh boy, wait until you see what's coming your way this morning. You will never be the same after you see this gentleman. Anyhow, what you're about to see and hear are the words of a pastor in Nigeria. Let me begin by thanking Peter Bishop for sharing this little video with me. Peter, I hope that you also sent this to every minister of government. The words that were uttered by this goodly gentleman are words which need to be heard by every minister of government in Grenada, and perhaps around the region as well. What this man said was the gospel truth. Listen up, pilgrims, listen up.
I have constantly said in this country, until Nigerians get to a stage to say, no, you can't be minister of power if it is generator that is powering your house and you have not provided generator for every other person. You cannot be minister of housing if you are not staying in a government apartment. You cannot be minister of health if you do not have your treatment in this country. You cannot be minister of education if your children are all schooling outside. You can't. Why? Because human beings have self-interest. That is what is called self-interest. If his children are going to go to the government secondary school, he will make sure that government secondary schools are well taken care of. If his family is going to go to the general hospital next door, he will make sure that general hospital is well taken care of. But as long as leaders do not share in the plight of the people, as long as leaders can fly to the US, to UK, to Dubai for their health care and condemn the people to this kind of conditions here, as long as that is the situation, we are not moving anywhere. So Nigerians will have to rise up and say, no, you can't be our minister for education because your children are not schooling here. So when you have a situation, rather than the people making sacrifice and demonstrating how much sacrifice you have made for the people, then we say, yes, you be our leader because you have suffered for us. You have denied yourself legitimate pleasures for our sake. That is what used to qualify people for leadership. Now, we have people who conquer us. They conquer us. Then they take the resources of our land to reconquer us and remain there, and it becomes difficult to move them out of power. But someday, as I always say, the revenge of the poor is at the corner. The revenge of the poor is coming. And that one, you will not be able to do anything about it. You can have your Jeep. You can have your generators. You can have everything bulletproof. But the revenge of the poor, it happened in France. It happened in Russia. It has just happened in Sudan. It will happen here. Unless we change our course, we will end up where we are heading. And where we are heading now, unfortunately, it's a violent revolution. That's where we are heading, unless we change our course. And I am not just talking of leaders in the national level. I'm not talking of presidents and governors and senators and House of Rep. I'm talking of all of us who are privileged. I hope you know. And many of us here, most of us here, are privileged. What is our concern for the people next door? For the poor people next door, what is our concern? What is even our concern for our Megadis? For those who do petty work for us, what is our concern? If that is not happening, it means we are failing as shepherds in our responsibility of being shepherds. I hope you know that in this Africa, in this Nigeria, there never used to be a distinction between the neighborhood of the rich and the neighborhood of the poor. I hope you know. I hope you know that poor people and rich people used to live together. That's the heart of the blacksmith. That's the heart of the king. That's the heart of it used to be together. It's a completely new, terrible thing that has happened to us. And people are enjoying it. They are enjoying it. They ask you what part of town you live in. And that immediately you tell them the part of town you live in, you know your status. And I am saying, by the time you segregate society, what used to be called apartheid, and Nigerians were in the forefront of fighting apartheid, where the white man said, look, you blacks, you live there. We white, we live here. That is exactly what we are doing to our fellow black people. Exactly. And you know, it makes it easier when revolution comes. I hope you know. It makes it easier. It means the poor people know where to go. And I challenge the authorities in our cities. I challenge town planners that this is not how to make plan towns. Let us start working. If we want our peace and safety and security in future, let us start working on what is called integrated cities, integrated estates, integrated settlements. If we want peace, the one we are on now, you will never have peace. We need to have integrated cities where the not so rich and the rich and so on live together and share. So that the children that are growing up privileged will know they are privileged when they see next door the other children. And they go to the same school, by the way. They go to the same school, by the way. When I was in primary school, Everybody went to that primary school. We never knew that anyone was rich or anyone was poor. And that helped us. That helped us. But the society we are creating today, I am saying it is not sustainable. What did I call it? It's not sustainable. We can't run a society like this for the next 100 years. It's not possible. So if you have a future, if you dream of a future for your children and grandchildren, you need to join me in shouting against this. If you dream of a future for your children and grandchildren, you need to join me in saying, this is inappropriate. This is dangerous. This is destructive. Like I said, it is not our high walls. It is not our barbed wires. It is not our electrified fences that will save us. What will save us is that the poor should be included at the dining table. Yes, the poor and the handicapped and the widow and the orphan, they should be included at the dining table. That is what will save us.
Wow. Powerful stuff, man. I mean, powerful stuff. That homily was delivered with deep conviction. And like I said, Pedro, I hope you pass that on to the right persons. Huh? Looking at Facebook here, John says, financial apartheid is the new apartheid. Margaret Francis says, my sentiments exactly. So see, it's not just the pastor thinking along those lines, and I bet many of you watching agree with that, what that man had to say there this morning. Arthur Langine obviously got his hands on that piece, and he said he sent it to them. I imagine he shared it with a number of friends. Let's also say good morning, Kipling, and we accept your blessings. Thank you. We send ours to you as well. And Pele Darbo is saying a pleasant morning to everybody. Benedict Cador, yeah, wonderful Wednesday, Benedict. Yeah. Arthur Langine is saying hi from New York. Peter is saying good morning. Yeah, Peter, I hope you got my message. Please, pass that on to the appropriate people. Now, let's get into our second little piece here. Have you noticed that over the past couple of years, the New Year's fireworks in Grenada have expanded to include the Carenage? I've been watching them from up here on Woolwich Road, and I will admit that they're trying. They were very, very good a year ago, and this past New Year's wasn't too bad either, not too shabby at all. The man behind that is none other than Dr. Terence Marischal. And I understand that his goal, I say that with a smile on my face because it makes me really happy, his goal is that not too long from now, he will have something like the ball drop at Times Square in New York. For those of us who don't go out on New Year's Eve, you sit at home, turn on the boob tube and look at the big ball coming down in Times Square, being broadcast by all the major networks. Well, I wish Terry well, but it's gonna be a while before we see that happening, all right? It's gonna be a while. In the meantime, I know that a lot of people hang out in Times Square on New Year's Eve, but not even the fireworks display in New York can touch. Margaret, I know you're gonna hate me for saying this, but not even the fireworks in New York can touch what you're about to see. Pilgrims, this is in Japan. Take a look. Thank you. you see that? Did you see that? Wow. Can you imagine standing on the carenage down here and looking at that? Oh my God, that would be awesome. I don't know if I'll live that long, but anyhow. And Edith Phillip on Facebook there says, ooh, beautiful. Okay, so I'll tell you what. Let us take our first little break right now, and we'll come back and give you something to work on. The National Report.
A natural disaster can change your life in minutes. Preparation is the best protection for your family and business. Prepare now. Create a disaster plan and make sure everyone knows what to do. Store water, non-perishable food, and medication. Remember basic emergency supplies such as batteries and flashlights. Trim overhanging trees. If trees near power lines are unsafe to trim, call Grenlec at 237 for assistance or advice. Install surge protectors to safeguard your electrical devices against outages and intermittent surges. For more information, visit grenlec.com.
Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
I'm always on the move. Training, traveling, competing. So it's good to know I have Coop Bank in the palm of my hand.
Introducing e-banking, one of many customer convenience services from Grenada Cooperative Bank. And there's more to come.
It's swift, simple, and secure.
Welcome home.
Juve chocolates, cocoa nibs, and cocoa balls from Diamond Estate Grenada are now available at Amazon.com, Amazon.ca, Amazon.co.uk, and GrenadaMarket.com. Try their sensational touch of nutmeg and a touch of ginger chocolates, 75% dark and rich, 100% pure cocoa, and their 60% dark and sweet chocolate bars today. Amazon Prime members enjoy free shipping on these orders in the USA, Canada, and Europe. GrenadaMarket.com. When you can't come to the island, the products of the island will come to you.
We've now been joined by Chris Davies. I'm not sure where she is, if she's in St. David this morning or if she's back in St. Patrick or whatever. But she's saying good morning to you folks. And she said they had some gorgeous rain last night. I know we had a bit of a drizzle down here. I don't know if we had rain per se, but it was pretty dry down here this morning. Anyhow, yeah, John says Carriacou, he's referring to the fireworks. He says Carriacous are better. Right, John? Right, John? Dream on. I'm not talking flambeau. I'm talking fireworks, guy. Huh? And he says here, 819, the first dropout. Yeah, John, I'm also seeing that dropout here. It's fine on my iPhone. Fine on my iPhone. But I'm seeing a dropout here on my, my desktop, huh? Anyway, who else is here right now? We've also been joined by Fragrance Emmanuel Bedeau Francique. Good morning, Fragrance, and thank you very much for joining us. Pilgrims, let's take a look at last night's National Report.
Grenada signs MOU to embark on phase two of Juvenile Justice Reform Project. Details to this story and more in the National Report. With the details to the news for Tuesday, May 28th, I am Leslie Ann Johnson. A project implementation consulting team has been engaged to to support Grenada and other OECS member states in developing the procedures, policies, assessment of programs, and staff capacity building geared towards changing the approach towards juvenile justice. The Grenada government, OECS Commission, and the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, committed to the second phase of the Juvenile Justice Reform Project in Grenada on Tuesday morning through the signing of a Memorandum of Understanding. JJRP2 seeks to strengthen juvenile justice systems to promote the rehabilitation and reintegration back into the society of youth in conflict with the law. Delroy Louison has the details.
Building on the first juvenile justice reform project, the Organization of the Eastern Caribbean States, the OECS, and the United States Agency for International Development, USAID, through the Juvenile Justice Reform Project Phase 2, targets youth age 18 and under who are in conflict with the law, that is, those who have committed offenses for which they could be prosecuted under the existing legislative framework in countries including Antigua Barbuda, Dominica, St. Kitts Nevis, St. Lucia, St. Vincent and the Grenadines, and Grenada. Therefore, in an effort to demonstrate their commitment to the cause, the OECS, the USAID, and the government of Grenada signed a Memorandum of Understanding on Tuesday at the Ministry of Infrastructure Development conference room. Addressing members of the media, Director General of the OECS Commission, Dr. Didicus Jules, underscored the importance of prevention in the juvenile justice reform project.
Sometimes we measure things by what they've achieved, but there are instances also where we need to assess things not only by what they have achieved, but by what they have avoided. And I think our engagement in this sector with USAID, with the JJRP, is a classical example of this. Because it is not just about finding alternative ways of dealing with youth in conflict with the law, but doing that in a way that ensures that they do not fall back into a cycle of crime, punishment, and recidivism that results in a deepening cycle of crime and criminality.
Principal Officer of the United States Embassy Grenada, Mr. Stephen Fram, speaks of the importance of reform as opposed to punishment for youth in conflict with the law.
Experience has shown that punishment alone does not change offending behavior. In fact, it sometimes reinforces it. The work required to make reform efforts successful is difficult and requires the efforts of many partners working together.
Minister for Social Development, Housing and Community Empowerment, Honorable Delma Thomas, says the rehabilitation and reintegration of youth into society will require all hands on deck.
We look forward to support that will provide through phase two, in particular, the development of programs for juveniles and strengthening of staff capacity to work with children in conflict with the law. We waited long for this occasion as it demonstrates the commitment of all of us to work in the best interest of our children.
This project will continue to introduce and implement a number of reform measures, which will result in more modernized systems of youth justice in the Caribbean region and will involve continued specialized training for practitioners and policymakers, the updating of laws, regulations, policies, and protocols for the treatment of youth in conflict with the law. For the National Report, I'm Delroy Louison.
The government of Grenada has provided additional equipment for the Royal Grenada Police Force to enhance the operation of the traffic department. Prime Minister and Minister for National Security, Dr. The Right, Honorable Keith Mitchell, on Tuesday handed over keys for five new motorcycles to Assistant Commissioner of Police Jessman Prince. In making the presentation, Dr. Mitchell said it is recognition of the serious problem we face with traffic and traffic violations in Grenada. He says the Ministry of National Security and the RGPF have been examining ways to confront the problem.
We also have a problem of, to some extent, in a level of irresponsible activities on our roads throughout the length and breadth of the country. We have to agree on that, because I, as a citizen myself, have witnessed that level of what almost I call craziness. Some of us use our vehicle almost like weapons on the road, a danger to ourselves and to members of the community. In fact, The steps that we are taking is basically to save some of us from ourselves.
The Prime Minister is optimistic that the use of the motorcycles and the initiative to introduce traffic wardens will bring about the desired result of helping to address the traffic-related problems being experienced across the country. Welcoming the timely donation, Acting Commissioner of Police ACP Prince said the new bikes will definitely help officers in the execution of their duties.
I can assure you, sir, that these motorcycles will be used effectively to assist us in managing our traffic situation in Grenada. So you would not be disappointed.
Newly installed officer in charge of the traffic department, Superintendent Randy Connaught, said the donation is an indication of government's commitment to managing the volume of traffic and incidents along public roads. He too pledged that the new bikes will be effectively used.
The traffic department, as I indicated, is delighted to have these motorcycles added to our fleet of assets. The motorcycles that we engage right now, they're pretty much aging motorcycles. And to combat the volume or the veracity that we have seen on the streets with respect to indiscretion as it relates to parking, the volume of traffic, and the congestion overall that has been created, is a national security issue. Citizen safety is high on the agenda in going forward, and we do intend to deploy these motorcycles right up the hand over here this morning. They are pretty much already assigned, and from the get-go, they will be hitting the ground running.
During Tuesday's presentation ceremony, Woman Detective Constable Shawnell Cummings was presented with an award by National Security Minister Dr. The Right Honorable Keith Mitchell. She copped the award as Top Caribbean Crime Fighter in the Amalgamated Security Services Association of Caribbean Commissioners of Police Regional Recognition Awards Program for Public Law Enforcement. This is the National Report. More news after the break.
Every summer, the Spice Island of Grenada is transformed into the Caribbean's biggest party, Spice Man. Come experience the warmth of our people,
trending theme fest,
the revelry,
the pageantry,
and why we are the Jab Nation.
The kids, our future shines on August 3rd in the Children's Carnival Frolic and the Junior Calypso Show.
Seven beauties take center stage as the Queen of Carnival is crowned on Majestic Thursday, August 8th. The prestigious Soca and Groovy Monarchs are crowned on Carnival Friday night, August 9th. Enjoy the pulsating rhythms of the Still Pan at the Junior and the Senior Panorama on Carnival Saturday, August 10th, and Real Steel, August 17th. The Mardi Gras crowns the Calypso Monarch on Carnival Sunday, August 11th. Two days of frolicking in the Caribbean sun kicks off on Monday morning, August 12th,
with the biggest
juve in the world, followed by pageant and Monday night mass. The creativity and splendor of our mass parades on the road, Carnival Tuesday, August 13th. Join us in the Jab Nation of Grenada, August 8th to 12th, for Spice Mass 2019. Many events, one carnival.
Continuing the news, with more than 200 athletes already registered, sporting enthusiasts can look forward to a weekend of keen athletic rivalry in the 2019 Whitsuntide Games scheduled for June 8th and 9th at the Kirani James Athletic Stadium. Speaking at the weekly post-cabinet briefing, Sports Minister Senator Nolan Cox says more than 100 local athletes will participate in the games, building on the success of the 2019 Carifta Games.
Currently, we have over 230-something athletes who have already registered to come in. That is separating apart from our national team, and I think more registrations are currently ongoing. From the national team side, we have about 100-something athletes who will be partaking. So a lot of our athletes from overseas will be here as well to represent Grenada. We would have Lyndon, of course, will be here. I think Josh is already here. Kurt will be here. Kurt Modest, Mark and Felix. A number of persons will be here to participate.
The 4x4 relay, which will feature our local athletes competing against the Trinidad and Tobago relay team, will be one of the major highlights of the games.
One of the highlights for us would be our 4x4 relay team, national relay team. We have been talking about this for a number of years. We believe that we have what it takes to represent in that category at the international level. So our national 4x4 relay team will be competing against the Trinidad and Tobago relay team in an effort to qualify for World Champions in Doha later on this year, which is September and October.
Prime Minister Dr. The Right Honorable Keith Mitchell has hailed former Jamaican Prime Minister Edward Siaga as one of the great contributors of his island's rich history. His comment was contained in a statement following the passing of the former Jamaican leader on Tuesday at the age of 89. Dr. Mitchell's statement read in part, and I quote, "When I entered the political arena back in 1984, Mr. Siaga was serving as Prime Minister of Jamaica at the time. As a new kid on the block then, I remember looking to leaders like him who had more experience on the political stage. I am immensely grateful for the words of advice that he shared with younger politicians like myself. While there are many things he will be remembered for, including being the longest serving parliamentarian in Jamaica, what's even more important is the contribution he would have made to the shaping of Jamaica's constitution when the country gained its independence from Britain. His passing, therefore, truly represents the end of an era, as he was the last surviving member of the team that framed the Jamaica Constitution. Mr. Siaga was a personal friend and a friend of Grenada and of the New National Party. I recall him being one of the regional leaders who favored the United States intervention in Grenada in 1983, which led to the return of democracy. Whichever side of the fence we sit on, we must appreciate that as our brother's keeper, we do what we believe is in the best interest. In politics, there will always be supporters and detractors, but it is only fitting that we recognize the invaluable contributions made by those who devote themselves to public life. At this time, I know that I speak for many Grenadians when I say we stand firmly with our brothers and sisters in Jamaica in mourning the loss of their former leader, Edward Siaga. I have already personally communicated my condolences to Prime Minister Andrew Holness." Unquote. And that's the National Report. I'm Leslie Ann Johnson.
Folks, there you have it, last night's edition of the National Report. And now time's now moved on to 26 minutes away from the hour. I'm not going to spend too much time here dilly-dallying around. I am so anxious to get to my guests this morning who are all the way across the pond visiting Lizzie. I wonder if these guys are going to go pay a visit to Lizzie. When you do, tell her Georgie Porgy says, "Hello, Lizzie." Okay, please do. Please do. Okay, let me take a little break here. We'll come back with Sherry and Winty after this.
My name is Jennifer James, and I've been making confectionery for the past 7 years. Growing up as a little girl, I always wanted to make these little things. Fudge, sugar cake, tamarind ball, these little things. I read something actually, and it said that tamarind itself is very good because it eliminates fat from the liver. You get the mature tamarind and you crack it, you shell it out. I would add a little baking soda, some spices. I would leave it to rest probably for about 2 hours and then add my sugar and just start kneading. I usually knead it hard enough so that I can roll it. When I finish roll it, I will paste it with the actual white or brown sugar. And you have a nice tamarind ball. I have been providing food here with tamarind ball about 6 years now. I started producing tamarind ball to sell for the school children. I thought I could advance somewhere. So I went to food fair and I asked one of the sales persons there to if they would be interested in selling my tamarind ball. And she told me yes. She told me to bring 20 packets to start with. It was really a joy for me because I wanted to extend on my little business. My name is Jennifer James and I work with the food fair to provide you with tamarind balls.
Boy, you, they gonna fly with kite now. The wind picking up.
I'm coming. Kaim, what are you doing?
Fly my kite.
Yeah, but not here. You can't fly kite near power lines, boy.
Why not? The wind good?
Because mommy say kite threads conduct electricity.
Yeah, kite. He's right. If your kite gets stuck in power lines, it can cause power outages, or even worse, it can get shocked.
Come, let's go and fly them in the pasture.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Kite threads conduct electricity. Do not fly kites near overhead power lines. This can lead to electric shocks and power outages. If your kite gets stuck in power lines, do not try to retrieve it. Release it and call Grenlec. Always fly kites in open areas. Keep your kites far away from roots. And remember, always clean up after yourself.
Grenlec, energizing our Grenada.
Alrighty, folks, take a look. There they are. There they are. What a beautiful couple. Good morning, Sharon. Good morning, Winty. And how art thou?
I'm fine, thank you.
You're
morning,
fine.
Guys. Morning, everybody.
You're fine, thank you. Have you totally rested from that very exhaustive presentation, which we're going to be seeing in just a wee bit?
It wasn't exhaustive at all.
Excuse me. Wow, I think the viewers are going to disagree with you when they see that. We'll get to that in just a wee bit. Sharon, tell me, how's this Reiki conference going?
The conference was very, very good. It ended last night. So we're now in Nottinghamshire at a place called Church Farm Lodge.
Church Farm Lodge.
It's very, very beautiful, but I'm inside because it's a bit too cold for me.
Cold at the end of May?
It is cold.
It's just chilly. It's about 17. It's not really cold. It's
just about 17. Well, it's about 26 or 27 here, Winty.
You understand? And there's a wind. So we just had lunch at a pub just around the corner, and I walked back and I thought there's no way I could do this outside. It's too cold.
Too cold. Okay. You're a Grenadian. You ain't no Brit.
But it's very nice. I would have loved to show Margaret. Actually, I'll take a picture and post it on Facebook so Margaret can see how pretty it is.
Boy, I'm sure she would enjoy that. So the conference went well, I would imagine.
Oh, very well. And in fact, I was responsible. I and my sister, Rosina, we were responsible for conducting the annual general meeting.
Okay.
We had over 100 Reiki masters from all over the world, Russia, Ukraine, Brazil, France, Germany, Denmark, UK, United States.
Argentina.
Yeah.
So do you think, and you said this is a conference that moves around from country to country. You guys are going to try bringing it to Grenada one of these days?
It's a massive thing to organize.
Okay.
Actually, next year it's in Uruguay, in South America. Mm-hmm. This has been my 22nd consecutive conference. I started in 1998 in Germany, 1999 was in Texas, 2000 in Belgium, 2001 Mexico, 2002 Germany, 2003 France, 2004 Chile, 2005 Denmark, 6 United States, 7 Netherlands, 2008 Hawaii, etc., etc.
You know, so you've been doing this thing for 22 years?
Yeah, 22 years, yeah.
Well, that explains where you get the energy we're going to see in just a wee bit. And by the way, John here, well, first of all, Margaret says, yes, Sharon, we like it warm, 80 degrees and above.
Thank you.
Come on, guys. Why don't you guys come spend a winter in Canada with me one of these days?
No, thank you.
I spent five winters in Canada doing my graduate work in the 60s. Oh, yeah, I know about that. That was cold.
That was cold. So come on, you coped, right?
Ocean of really cold.
Pardon me?
20 years ago, I was in Canada for winter, and I pledged never to go back in the winter. I went back twice in May, and still too cold for me.
All right. And by the way, Margaret says she's going to wait for your picture.
Yes.
And Winty, John, and Gary Koo's saying, you guys are now in cricket mode. Is that right?
Yes, indeed. Indeed. I got my tickets for the Pakistan match on Tuesday. And of course, you know, Pakistan matches on the 31st on Friday. And I am going to the Australia matches where we are both going. And I'll get my tickets in a few days' time for that.
And by the way,
I ordered them a long time ago online, but they don't send them to you less than a week in advance, you know? So just find out where you are and they UPS them to you, yeah.
Okay. By the way, did I hear that the West Indies were kicking butt yesterday?
Oh, 421, if you please. Yes, you see.
Did you get to that game?
No. That was a warm-up game somewhere. Yeah, I don't know where that was.
Yeah,
but it must have been in Northampton as well.
I see yesterday's victory making headlines down here. So that's good. You know, I'm sure it's sparking a little bit of enthusiasm or optimism for the upcoming series.
It was a big thing. I don't ever remember us making 421 in a 50-over match. I mean, I think that's a record for us.
But that was warm-up. Let's see what they do in the real thing.
Yeah, well, you know, wonders never cease, Sharon.
And, you know, I think they're comfortable. They're confident with the management team. Mm-hmm. So that gives them the go-ahead to do their best.
Okay. So your itinerary from today, and you're coming back here, what, the middle of next month?
The 17th, that's right.
17th.
We're here today with some of Winthrop's Reiki masters, and they have the same master. So they call themselves siblings, Reiki siblings.
Okay.
And then we go to Nottinghamshire tomorrow. We're in North Hampshire today. We go to Nottinghamshire tomorrow. And then we go on to Northern Ireland and go back to London, and then we come back to you.
So wait a minute. By the time this grand tour is over, you would have gone to how many cities?
Not many, actually. Not many. Northamptonshire, Belfast, back to London.
Six.
Okay.
And then you're going to climax things with cricket. World Cup cricket.
That's right.
All right. Just before I move on here, tell me, cricket, you still optimistic, Winty?
Definitely. Is the Pope Catholic? I'm an optimist by nature.
Okay.
I always believe in the most favorable outcome.
All right.
When that doesn't happen, I say, well, next time will be different.
It's good. And that's good. You know, if you're not going to be optimistic, what the heck do you have to live for? You know?
Exactly.
Yeah. All right, folks, let me tell you. These are a couple of my very, very good friends. And a couple of nights ago, when was it, boy? I'm not sure. It must have been Monday night?
Monday night.
I was about to turn in at about 1:30 in the morning. And I just decided to take one last look at my WhatsApp. There was a video on there which Sharon sent to me. This video featured a performer. Yeah, you heard me. A performer whom you happen to be looking at on the left of your screen right now. Now, I have known this guy for a number of years, okay? And with all due respect, let me say to you, I mean, I'm no spring chicken, and I'm sure the man's just at least a few hours older than I am. I'm 67.
He could be a father.
Pardon me?
He could be a father.
He could be my father. Oh, Sharon, that makes it even worse yet. This gentleman was attending a cabaret earlier on that evening. Like I said, this was 1:30 in the morning for me, and apparently that very same night in England there, I think 5 hours ahead of us. This gentleman got on stage and put on a show, and obviously Sharon herself must have seen some humor in this. So she decided, boy, I gotta share that with George. So she sent it. And the moment I saw it, after picking myself up off the floor, I said, boy, I gotta put this on the air. I really have to put this thing on the air. But I was not gonna do that without their permission. So I sought and obtained Wendy's permission to do this. Enough said. Take a look. I hope you're sitting down, and I hope your heart is in good shape. Okay, I really hope your heart is in good shape. Take a look at this. Ago, this man could be my father. Huh? Could you believe that? Sharon, Margaret says here, Winthrop, you rock. Anybody who says otherwise just jealous of your moves. Three cheers. And Edith Phillip, Edith says, James Brown, so nice. Sharon, you actually shot that video?
Yes, I did.
Sharon, you're standing in the audience with your cell phone shooting this video. What the heck's going through your mind?
Actually, it was the first time that I didn't go hide while he was dancing.
Oh, so he's done this before?
Listen to me. Some years ago, when we just met, we were at a New Year's Eve party, and when he started to dance, the people just cleared the floor, and he was in there alone. So the Prime Minister came, was Keith Mitchell at the time, and he said to me, Sharon, isn't that your husband? I said, sir, I have never seen this man in my life. He clears the floor. And those in Grenada, if you really want to see him in action, go down one Friday night to Prickly Bay. And
oh, really?
Yes.
Aha. I gotta check that out. Donna Joseph says, this gentleman is the bomb. He rocks the party.
But I'm only 81, so I'm still a young man.
Tell me something. So, Winty, you didn't have to use nutmeg the following morning?
No, not at all. I took it in my stride.
Winty,
it was a cabaret, so many people performed. And so, but when he was finished, I stayed about half an hour, and then I went down to my cabin. And it was Minister One when he actually got home. He partied whole night.
Look at that smirk on his face. Winty, you gotta be damn proud of yourself, fella.
And guess what?
Tell me.
It was only I only decided to do that on the spur of the moment, you know.
Oh, really?
On Sunday.
Yes.
So when I put a table there, I didn't know what a table was for, so I decided to jump on it. There was no rehearsal or anything.
Winty, you might get labeled as a table dancer, you know, and you know the connotation behind table dancing. Huh?
I didn't even know he was going to do that until the person introduced and said something about Winthrop, and I looked up and I saw him there, and I thought, no. So I pulled my phone out. I don't normally walk with it, but I thought something might happen. I might need my phone. So I recorded him.
Margaret says, 81? Seriously?
Only 81. 81 years young. And guess what? I improve with age. So when I'm 90, I expect to be dead.
Oh, yeah. There is hope for me yet, you know. Here I am creaking when I wake up in the morning with my 67-year-old bones, and you behaving like that. She goes on to say, keep dancing, my friend. And, well, you just said you're going to keep on dancing because you're getting better with age. You're like good wine, eh?
Tell Margaret, if she see Winthrop run up Market Hill.
Yeah.
I wouldn't believe. I'm taking my time. It takes me about a good 5 minutes to go up Market Hill, and he runs up Market Hill.
Market Hill is a place I avoid climbing, period, even at night.
I don't have any formal exercise, so I have to move quickly when I'm walking and, you know, between buildings on campus or whatever. That's my exercise, no formal exercise.
Would you attribute, the fact that you engage in Reiki, would you contribute that to that sort of behavior?
good genes.
I wouldn't say it's just good genes. It has to do with lifestyle. He is a vegetarian, and he drinks once in a blue moon, he'll have a beer. So two nights ago, he told me, he said he had two beers. I said, really? Because I know he had a German beer. He insists he wanted a German beer. And when he told me he had two beers, I thought, well, you had another one? The other beer was a ginger beer.
I'm going to have to remember that. Winty, I don't know if you know somebody named Hazel Ferguson, but she says here, she says, I know him from Prickly Bay. You have to give him room when he start.
There you go.
Hey, listen, man, why don't you, you know, anytime you're having, anytime you feel like it, come and give us a performance here and we'll do this thing live.
You can take it live to Prickly Bay.
Yeah, my fee is $1,000 an hour.
We can afford that, right, Sharon? We can afford that. Well, Winty, let me tell you, my friend, I was very impressed, and I want to extend my congratulations. And I can tell, just looking at what's going on here on Facebook, these people, they marvel at you, and deservedly so. Thank you very much. Keep it up, my friend. When I grow up, I want to be like you.
Life is to be enjoyed. Life is to be enjoyed.
Good for you, my friend. Good for you. And I guess you, Sharon, have adopted that motto as well.
That life to be enjoyed, of course.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, guys, we're going to check you out next week. And next week, you're probably at cricket, right?
Yes. Not on the Wednesday, but we'll be in the area of cricket, yeah. Near to the cricket ground. So the hotel near the cricket ground, yeah.
So you will have time to talk with us on Wednesday.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
Okay.
And by then, I'd have some scores. We'll know some of what's happening in the cricket, yeah. Some initial games.
Yeah, we'll see if you'll be able to shake and bake like you did a couple of nights ago after you see the scores. Take it easy, folks.
Oh, yes.
Take it easy. Thanks a lot.
All right.
Okay, there. All right. Listen.
Whoa. The guy is good. He is good. And like I said, when I grew up, I want to be like him. Pilgrims, it's 2 minutes away from the top of the hour, so let's take our final little break here, and we'll come back and wrap it up.
Juve chocolates, cocoa nibs, and cocoa balls from Diamond Estate Grenada are now available at Amazon.com, Amazon.ca, Amazon.co.uk, and GrenadaMarket.com. Try the sensational touch of nutmeg and a touch of ginger chocolates, 75% dark and rich, 100% pure cocoa, and their 60% dark and sweet chocolate bars today. Amazon Prime members enjoy free shipping on these orders in the USA, Canada, and Europe. GrenadaMarket.com. When you can't come to the island, the products of the island will come to you.
Mouth Open Story Jumbo comes to Brooklyn and Washington, D.C. featuring the humor and storytelling of Ricardo Kings Douglas.
They say she comes all the way up here to Toronto to shop for cosmetics and go back down.
Roll back the years in Brooklyn with Lord Nelson.
Lord Nelson.
Also in the Brooklyn concert, Quick USA.
And in Washington,
Diane and Friends.
And Julian Moore.
Washington, D.C., Saturday, June 8th.
And Father's Day, Sunday, June 16th.
In Brooklyn, at the Tropical Reflection Ballroom on 4501 Glenwood Road from 6 p.m.
It's the perfect Father's Day treat.
Tickets $30 in advance. Available at Eventbrite and popular outlets. Or call 347-350-4285 in Brooklyn and 240-460-0442 in Washington, D.C., Maryland.
Brooklyn.
Special guest, the Mighty Sparrow, will be joined by cultural ambassadors and preservationists to be recognized with New York State proclamations. They include Lord Nelson, Derek Ventor, Heron Rockin' J. Douglas, Jetta Benjamin, Lambert, and the Matadors, and the Quake USA Cultural Organization. Additionally, two lucky patrons will get to stay free at the award-winning Blue Horizons Garden Resort in Grenada for 3 nights, including breakfast and a dinner at La Belle Creole Restaurant, sponsored by Tropical Reflection Ballroom, Blue Horizons Gardens Resort, The Pettifer, Caribbean Times Newspaper, Dr. Derek Lezama, Century 21 Achievers Realty, Attorney Glenroy George, The Otley Law Firm, and Funk Media NYC.
Washington, D.C., Saturday, June 8th.
And Brooklyn, Father's Day. Mouth open, story jump out.
Company, tell your friends, tell your family, we cover householders comprehensive, motor and even fire too, contractors all risk burglary, public liability, professional.
St. George's. For more information, call 440-2434.
Tell everybody.
Alrighty, folks, just before we pull the curtain down, today's inspirational words, which come to you from the book of Colossians, Colossians chapter 3, verses 5 to 9. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature: sexual immorality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways and the life you once lived, but now you must also rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language. Remove them all from your lips. That reading from Colossians chapter 3, verses 5 to 9. Okie dokie, folks. Time's moved on to 2 minutes after the hour. Thank you so much. By the way, for those of you who have been having some hassles with the stream out there, I mean, look at it. Absolutely perfect on my little gadget here, my iPhone. But on the desktop, which is a PC, hassles. So whenever you're reporting to me that you have an outage, and I really wish you would, please let us know two things: where you are and what device you're using. Are you using a laptop, a tablet, a smartphone, whatever? And where you are, New York, Toronto, Zurich, wherever. Thanks a lot, my dear friends. You have yourselves a wonderful day, and I do pray God's blessings upon you. See you tomorrow.